Rich, you can sit in the front. Danner, Brocky, you guys come up front.
Come up down in the front. That's great. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to First Niagara Center for this special day. It's great to be a part of it, and you've heard enough from me, so I'm going to pass it over to John, and he'll have a few words, and Scott and Troy will as well, and we'll open it up for questions afterwards. So, John, take it away.
Well, I'm very overwhelmed by how many media representatives are here and fans, my family, some teammates, coaches. Thanks for showing up. As I'm sure you're aware of, I'm here today to announce my retirement. It's been a great ride, 24 years in the best place to play in the National Lacrosse League in Buffalo. Also wanted to thank the Buffalo organization for all they've done for me and my family over the years. I want to thank all the players, present, past. I played with some great players, my coaches, general managers, player directors, lawyers. Everybody's been a big part of my career. And also want to thank my family. They've been a big part of my career, especially the last 10 years of my career. My wife, Katrina, definitely has been a big part of the last 5-6 years. If it was for her, I probably would have retired a lot sooner, excuse me. I also want to thank all the fans. I think that's the hardest part of letting go, is not being able to perform in front of all my fans. Buffalo fans, my fans, lacrosse fans. It's the game of lacrosse has been in my blood since I was 4 years old, and it's definitely hard for me to let go. And it's been a great ride, and you know, everything's got to come to an end. And as much as I want to play, you know, my mind's like, you know, go, go, go. And unfortunately, my body's not following anymore, and it's, you know, it's time to let go and start a new chapter in my life. So I want to thank everybody for all your support, and thanks for being here today. Thank you.
We can pass it over to Scott if you want to follow up on that.
Yeah, I just want to, you know, thank John and his family for giving him to us for as long as they have. I think I can speak for the whole organization, fans of Bandit Land and the city of Buffalo when I say it's been a joy to watch you. It's been a joy to get to know you. I think the most impressive thing about John is how long he's done it for. 24 years at the top level is pretty impressive. You know, his last game he had 5 points. The game before that he had 4 goals. So. It's not that he can't play anymore in terms of his talent. He just, like he said, his body can't do it anymore. But I think another thing that's pretty impressive about John is he's done it with class. He's done it with respect and humility. And you know, he's the first guy to give praise to everybody else and not himself. And I think today and hopefully the rest of the season, the fans and the organization can give him the praise he deserves. So thanks, John.
Thanks.
Troy, if you want to follow up on that.
Well, I'd like to congratulate him, too, on an unbelievable run. I was fortunate to play with him as a player, you know, coach against him, coach with him, you know, and he's been incredible. He's been the face of the NLL, the best athlete, bar none, and that's in any sport. What he's done for our league and our sport and our franchise is unbelievable. So, you know, congrats. I'm also going to make an announcement that JT will be staying in the Buffalo Bandit organization. JT will be the new offensive coach of the Buffalo Bandits.
They couldn't completely get rid of me.
We have some microphones. If we have some questions from the media, we could certainly open it up at this point in time on either side. Jerry, yeah, sir.
John, you said 7 years ago, I think it was the day of the title game, I think one day it's just going to hit me that I'm done. Is that how it happened, or was it a little more gradual?
Yeah, I think it hit me probably a couple times last season when I was standing on the offensive end. I thought to myself, yeah, I think I should have cut there, and I didn't really move anywhere. So when that starts happening, you know, it's hard not to think about retiring. But, you know, you mentioned 7 years ago. I think the first time I was asked about my retirement was in my early 30s. I'm going to say 32, 33, because back then not many players played until the age of 40. I think Bill Gary played, I don't know, maybe until he's 42, but he was a goalie, so they can play forever. So, you know, I've been asked the question, you know, are you going to play next year, for about 15 years now? So I can finally say, yeah, I'm done.
Hey, John.
Sean.
Sean Stepner with Channel 7 here in Buffalo. What do you think allowed you to last this long and perform at such a high level until almost age 47?
Well, I think it's the style of my play. I've never really relied on one thing in terms of my size or speed. And I think I've always tried to use my teammates as much as possible, and I try not to put too much on my shoulders. And I just, you know, think the game. And I'm a student of the game, and, you know, whether I'm on the bench or watching a video, I'm always trying to watch and learn and try to figure out what I can do to surprise the defense after I kind of lull them to sleep, if I will. It's like just kind of going, stepping out of the routine. Because a lot of times in sports, a lot of the same things happen over and over again. So you got to find a way to be creative to make things happen, even at my age. So I think, you know, my mind has got me through it. You know, definitely not my speed or size. And I think the other thing too is just my will to want to prove people wrong. You know, again, he's too old, too slow. You know, I got that early in my career too. He's too small, too slow. So I think the challenge of, you know, proving people wrong and trying to be the best I can be.
What do you hope people remember you by? What do you hope your legacy is?
Honestly, just, you know, a guy who's a hardworking player, good teammate, and somebody who loved the game of lacrosse.
Anybody else? Jerry?
You live in Toronto and you're Canadian, and must have been opportunities you could have played up there. What made you remain in Buffalo and stay a Bandit all these years?
Well, I got drafted in 1992 by Detroit and then quickly traded to Buffalo, which was great because Buffalo is a lot closer to me. It's about an hour and a half drive. And I've been here for 24 years. It's been a good relationship between myself and the Buffalo Bandits organization. I've never had any reason to want to leave or to leave. I did hear rumors years ago that one of the coaches was going to trade me, but that never happened, luckily. But a lot of it was definitely, you know what, to be honest with you, I'd like to stand here and say, yeah, and I do love playing my career in Buffalo. I didn't really have the opportunity to make that choice, actually, because I was always considered a franchise player, so I never really had a chance until later in my career. But I still would have been here anyway. You know, it's the best place to play. I love playing here. And I think part of my longevity is playing in the same team, just being comfortable with everything, having that role, not feeling like I have to step on anybody's toes. I think if I was to move teams, let's say in my late 30s, you know, I got to kind of find my role on that team, and I think that's hard to do at that age. So, you know, I love playing in Buffalo. I'm lucky that I've played here so long, and what better way to end my career than here in Buffalo?
Down here.
Steve Berman with NOL.com. John, how did you see the game evolve in your 24 years playing? And for Troy, other than being the all-time leading scorer in the league, why are you excited to have him behind the bench with you?
So what was the question for me? Yeah, well, that's a tough question to answer because I've obviously gotten a lot older, 47 on Friday. So this is an early birthday present, but I'm going to obviously say faster, but with time I'm obviously getting slower too, but definitely more athleticism. Even though a lot of teams play the offense, defense, strategy, still the guys are a lot more athletic, they're a lot more skilled, and definitely in much better shape than we were, you know, 20 years ago. So the league's headed in the right direction in terms of the product on the floor. Is now a matter of getting, you know, recognized as a legitimate professional lacrosse board, which it should be.
Troy, did you want to?
I'm excited to have John on the bench. You know, he's a very intelligent person, very intelligent lacrosse player. As we all know, he's a teacher. He teaches real well. And the big advantage, too, is you know, how can the offensive guys not give 100% game in, game out practice when he's behind the bench, when they know that what he's made of. That's huge. So, you know, having Rich and JT behind the bench, you know, that's a lot about the Buffalo Bandits. Those two guys, you know, bled orange and black and still do. And I'm excited to see our offense next year.
Yeah. Okay.
Hi, John. Dave Buchanan from WGR Radio and Bandits Radio. Is there a moment in your career that you remember the most, maybe one of the four championships? And for Scott, is the organization ready to announce any kind of ceremony for John for the home opener, any kind of jersey retirement or anything?
Well, I'd have to say the 1992 overtime winning goal in Philadelphia would be the first memory I have and one of my favorite memories playing for Buffalo.
Yeah, we will be doing something this year. We just don't know our schedule yet, so once we get that, we'll look at the dates, talk it over with John and see what's best for his family and the organization. And it's only right to put his number up there with Rich and Darris. I mean, they're the three big names that if you talk about the Bandits, you can't not name them. So, yeah, we will be doing something. We just wait for our schedule to come out.
Anybody else? Over here. Mr. John Gertler.
John Gertler, Bandits Radio. John, for years I've said that you make players want to play better out on the floor. How will you translate that now, being an assistant coach? I want to be a better man.
Yeah, I think from all the coaching positions, I think offensive coach is probably the toughest one because you have a lot of different ideas and a lot of guys that want to produce, and it's just a matter of keeping everybody happy. And I think that's the best way of doing it is try to get them to share the ball as much as possible and see all their teammates, not just themselves, and not having to be that guy who makes the great play all the time. So all I can do is, you know, tell them, you know, things that I used to do. And it's regardless of shooting percentages of who it is, if somebody else has a better opportunity, that's who gets the ball. And, you know, if you're going to hold the ball too long or, you know, not pass it to your teammates, you're going to put yourself in probably more in trouble most times than none in terms of, you know, getting double teamed or triple teamed. You know, just move the ball, keep the ball flowing throughout the offense, try to get everybody as many touches as possible, make everybody feel like they're part of the game. And I think things will open up for every individual eventually. I don't know if I answered your question. Just rambling.
And another one? Do we have somebody else? Over here. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't see you on the other
side. Morning, gentlemen. Ricky Mazzella, WSCB 89.9, Springfield College, Massachusetts. John, I wanted to ask you, you've been an innovator of the game, in addition to all of these records and all of the brilliant play that you've had. With your innovation and also with some of the innovation of your peers, how is that going to move the sport of lacrosse forward and promote the game to maybe your liking or to the liking of Troy or anybody else that you've played with?
Will you ask me? Sorry.
With the way that you played the game and with this current state of the game, how do you think that'll progress the sport?
I don't know the way I played the game would progress the sport because I was pretty, you know, I'm not very flashy. Yeah, I score, you know, from behind the net a few times, but it's not as hard as people think. I think just being creative is the way I played and playing smart and making the right play. And playing hard it would hopefully make the game a little more popular. I don't know. I'm not, like I said, I'm not a guy who's going to thrill people many times. I usually try to make the right play. I don't try to do too much. And unfortunately, I don't, I mean, Troy said I'm an athlete, but, you know, I'm not the fastest. I don't jump very high. I'm not the most athletic person in the world. You know, I rely more on my brain. And studying the game and just the determination to do well and to win and create opportunities that other people might not see that are there. You know, that's how I've played the game. Whether that's going to enhance the game or not, I don't know.
Anybody else before we wrap up? Again, thank you, everyone, for being here. John and Scott and Troy will be around if any media like any follow-up. And again, thank you all and have a good day.